We've seen a lot of great goals and saves this year.
That one was nice.
We certainly have. And we've been monitoring all the best goals of the year. And on this show, we are going to crown a first half goal of the year champion. But first, let's take a look back at who has held the title over the first season here. Yeah, who's held the belt? I wish we had a belt. That would make it extra fun. We're going to get
just a regular belt.
All right, first, Tomáš Hertl, very early in the season, first night of the year, puts up.
We forget about that. Was really sweet, Ruffer.
Yeah, a little shake and bake.
Not easy.
Right there, Cam Fowler.
Yeah,
too.
Good player.
How about this one though, from Pasta? This one set the internet ablaze. Woo!
Yeah. He didn't just do that, did he?
Yeah. Poor Matt Benning. He doesn't want to see that. He's like, you know, come on.
Like, you make one fantastic move on a goal, that's fine, but you're making two like that?
Yeah.
Come on.
I feel like anytime someone's falling while they score, it gets extra points.
Yeah, and when you're able to kind of toe-drag it a little bit from your feet, Anthony Duclair getting it done. That is some sweet moves by that young man from Columbus.
Talk about sweet moves. How about Sid the Kid Crosby just embarrassing the Oilers?
Yes, this was the talk of the town early on, talk of the league at the beginning of the year. This is the trip where the Penguins were on fire out west, and a lot was due to Sidney Crosby, and this was one of those crazy plays right there by him. That was like, what is that, overtime winner, wasn't
overtime
it?
Winner.
Certainly was.
Overtime
and
winner.
And this is a goal that had Kevin Weeks so hyped.
I'm hyped! Give me the full hype there. Give me the full hype.
Spinorama.
Coast.
Up the ice.
Yeah, this was really nice. Really nice. Just blows right around the Canadians and then beats a fellow by the name of Carey Price.
And what about Rasmus?
Yeah, this was nice. This was nice, and then nice Selly as well afterwards. But beating Brent Burns and coming in, there it is.
There, you can't not put that Selly
in there. You got to have it in there.
Exactly. Here is a look at the goal of the year. Leaderboard.
They've been nice.
Yeah.
I like it. Yeah. They're working
I was just putting a little extra flavor
on it.
But Neil Pionk held the title for the longest, 21 days. I personally couldn't believe it when he dethroned Sidney Crosby, but he
shocked.
Do that. If there was an award on this show for the Selly of the year so far, I think we all know Rasmus would have had it in spades.
Absolutely.
Not every goal of the year candidate obviously got to hold the title.
Yeah.
Any honorable mentions from where you're standing?
Yeah, I'm going to go with Pontus Aberg of the Anaheim Ducks. He had a really nice goal. We're going to show it to you. But this is kind of a first half of the season achievement award for him. Really nice. Kind of turns around poor Yoki Ryan there. New Jersey kid. Good Jersey boy. But unfortunately on this one, he gets toasted. But Aberg has come in there off waivers. And he's scored 10, 11 goals now for the Anaheim Ducks. So really nice play by Aberg. Want to give him a little love.
Yes. Yes, they needed some help, too.
Yes, they
opportunities
did.
Opportunities are from him. He's stepping up. Andre Kasha's coming off a good season last year, filling the net. So they need that.
So I don't think this is the goal of the year to this point, but I do love a good tic-tac goal. So I just want tic-tac-toe goal, excuse me. And this was a good one from the Flyers, and it's Dadonov with the finish.
Yeah, it was a nice play.
Or excuse me, the Panthers.
We got you. We got you.
Yeah, we got
you. Look at that right there. That was a really nice passing play.
Who's your daddy?
How about Dadonov's season he's having now?
Yeah.
A really good one.
So good.
He's a great player. Really talented guy.
We've talked Flyers so much this
week. I know. It's been a lot of Flyers.
Rolls off the tongue.
That gritty.
Flyers. All about the Flyers this week. But that's okay because
it's been a good story.
It's been a good week for the Philadelphia Flyers. We apparently have an honorable mention for goal of the year from the control room as well.
Okay, what do we got? What do we got?
I believe it comes courtesy of Kunockle.
Oh, yeah. Remember this one.
One similar
to this years ago. Remember when Ovi scored one like that in Arizona?
Yeah.
A little more crazy, but it was kind of the same idea.
Oh, I remember epic Ovi one.
Yeah, similar idea. Nice for Tommy Kunockle.
All right, guys. The time is nigh.
It is.
If you had to cast a vote right now for goal of the year out of what we've just seen, what goal would get your vote?
Mine would be the Neil Pionk.
Over Crosby?
The Pionk one was difficult. Yeah. Not just the coast-to-coast, which is very difficult, but the spinorama at the beginning was just an extra flavor.
You know what? I think that I'm going to have some of that flavor on top as well, and I'm going to go with Pionk as well.
Because you're both going with Pionk.
I'm going to go Pionk as well because I think you're right. I mean, the spin, to go down the ice, and then to go around the defenseman, and then come in and then to beat Carey Price.
Yeah.
Carey Price.
You beat Carey Price at Madison Square Garden in your building. You weren't even drafted. So, yeah,
I'm going to go with a good Nova Scotia boy, Sidney Crosby, in overtime.
Not so bad.
That's a pretty good goal.
Pretty nice goal, Jackie.
Let's take a look at it. Ayo.
Well, you know, Jackie, that's a nice goal right there.
Pretty nice goal.
Ryan Strome was so bad for him, he got beat so bad they traded him. Now he's a Ranger.
Burn, baby, burn.
Yeah. Sorry, Ryan. He's a great guy. He's doing well with the Rangers. Happy to be there.
You know what, though? We're only at the end of December, and we've already had so many awesome goals. I just can't wait for the second half of the season.
That's right.